Okay, YouTube, we're trying again here with bleeding a 3400 motor here. This is a Pontiac Aztec 2003, but this motor is very common in a lot of the cars that are out there. You're seeing this correctly. That is a plastic water bottle with the top cut off right there. And I've got it put right on the end. It looks like this. We're not going to put our face over it, but you can see with the camera. Where the bleeder valve, see the bleeder valve here from the opposite side of the motor? I've taken the entire bleeder valve out. I saw this on YouTube with another person's video, and honestly, between you and me, I didn't even think it was going to be possible or it was going to work. There is no seal, it's just an exact fit, tight enough fit, that it's going across there with the water bottle popped on there. You can see the air bubbling through the top as it's going. Now, normally, we'd have to remove this bar here, we'd have the pressure cap there, we'd be using a bucket, something like this here. And then the issue became, what I think the issue became for me, is the angle and the amount of water, if you would, getting high enough to get up over top of the motor. And also, imperative, really important, you need to turn the heat on in your heater and in the fan too, with inside the vehicle, so the water will go through the heater core, okay, back to the antifreeze, it'll go back to the heater core in the back. So when you do it, if you're bleeding the air up here, but you don't open up the system on the inside and it's got air in it being drained out, you're going to still have air in your system, and that can cause overheating, if you do have overheating, pull over immediately, let it sit for a minute or two, and typically that the air bubble will come out of here, the antifreeze will come back, and then down in there where we started with that bolt that was giving us the trouble, that's where the thermostat is. The antifreeze, the hot antifreeze, will touch it, car will open back up. So usually sitting by the side of the road, if it takes a minute, that's probably a long time, maybe two, then you'll see your gauge, your temperature gauge, will go back up to normal again, okay? One of the tricks it looks like is going to be a little bit here, is going to be getting that plug, this piece right here, back in. Looks like this right here. Okay? Getting this back into that hot antifreeze hole without letting the antifreeze escape or having expansion. If I shut the car off, it's going to come pouring out. So anyway, that's the name of the game. Always, always, always be careful because there's pressure in there. If you come flying, we're not going to look down in here. If you come popping out of there at any second, if a big bubble went by, we don't want to do that. Always recommend a qualified mechanic be doing this work. You can see I'm here doing it on the cheap in my backyard. I'm taking the risk. I don't recommend anybody else that hasn't tried it before to do that on their own. Always be careful around hot fluids, and you know they're running over 100, well over 100 degrees inside there right now for this vehicle to be showing warm on the thermostat. So hey, I'm kind of surprised, but at the same time, pretty cool. So we've got another way to be able to basically perk the system, get the air out of the system of this 3400 GM motor, and we're going to see if we can get a couple more 1,000 miles out of it without overheating this motor and blowing a head gasket. Okay, continuing on, my goal right now is to not get this too full, because eventually here, what's going to happen is I'm going to be pulling that off of there, and I don't have the plug at the second anyway. I don't have a plug to catch the antifreeze, so it's going to make a mess when it comes off of there. So my challenge, once this bubbling gets down to a bare minimum, right, which we're getting close, my challenge is going to be to get, by the way, if you needed to get the RPMs, the engine rev, right here, if I grab this and just bring it up very slightly, you can see the level go up and down in there. You see a few more air bubbles coming out. You do not want the fluid to go down so far that it sucks air in through here, okay? You just want to give it a real slight tap, trying to get the air bubbles, the last of those air bubbles out of the motor. RPMs might be sitting at 2,000 RPMs. They don't need to be much higher than that. In my case here, my heater's open. You still see some air coming through. It's getting pretty close though, this is close. And again, I just got my hand on the where the accelerator cable goes through. And we're gonna let it off. And last couple bubbles here coming out. Now, what I did was I took that piece on the end, and I've got it's a electrical tape wrapped around it, and then I'm gonna take this extender right here. And this particular one has a locking hole. This to not stick my face into this hole. I don't think there's gonna be air pressure in there, but we don't want a surprise. But I wanna be able to do this, see? I can take this upside down. It's not falling out, all right? Pretty well in there. And then I wanna be able to thread this down into that hole on a good day. I don't wanna double thread it in there. So I'm not, I can feel it catching. All right, so my answer for how to catch the last of that little bit of antifreeze is in the bottom there. I really don't want it to go down on the motor. It's unnecessary. I stuck some blue paper towel in there. I'm just lifting up, and that should do it at that point. See, it catches the antifreeze, so it's not sitting out all over the place making a mess. And now the only question is just got to make sure this part here. Now, that's a 10 millimeter bolt. Certainly looks like I've got it on there okay. I use the 11 because you can see the tape right here. Maybe you can't, there's electrical tape. See if I can show you right there. That's the electrical tape that was inside the 11 millimeter. I'm gonna pop that off, put the 10 on. And that's gonna go right over top of there, like so. And we're gonna just lightly, I'm not gonna over tighten it, just lightly snug that up. Looking to see what we got there. So that's the fix for the getting the air out the backyard mechanic way for today, okay? So basically, be careful around the hot fluids. I always recommend having a professional do it if you have the choice of being able to have that alternative. But if you ever did want to try using a water bottle to be able to get the air out of your via 3400, motor, this would be a way to be able to do it.